welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today I'm going to do a vlogmas a little bit differently because I thought it would be good to chat about weight loss, which I had previously talked about in a video a couple of weeks back, and I have just not got round to shooting the part two, so I thought, yeah, it's probably a good idea to do that now, especially with the fact Christmas is on the way, and at Christmas everyone worries about weight gain and the way they look, what they're gonna wear, and what they're eating and all of those sorts of things. So the biggest question I'm asked across social media at the moment is, how did I lose 4 stone? And people just saying really nice things like, oh, you look so much better, and oh, you look so lovely in that dress or that outfit you're wearing. And whilst obviously that's so nice and I really do appreciate that, and I feel better, I feel more myself, it also makes me kind of think in a more like negative way, on the side of, did I not look nice before when I tried to look nice or wear something pretty, or, you know, were people not thinking the same when I was a significantly bigger than I am now? So I thought there'd be a couple of different things to talk about there. So first of all, I wanted to just talk about social media, working as a content creator, and the way that people kind of view you online and what people think about you, say about you, feel like that they should be able to say about you, and then talk about Christmas and weight loss with Christmas, and then finish off with how I got to where I am. But before we do all of that, so I had a few comments asking where Hazel was and why she hadn't been in any videos recently. She's here, she's fine. I still have her, if that's what anyone was kind of getting at, and we are never, ever, ever not gonna have her. Yeah, she's just quite a quiet dog. I know she's one, and people often expect Labradors to be really bouncy and nuts at this age, and you have your moments, but you're not really, are you? But no, she's here, she's good, and probably gonna sit here now for the rest of my video. People's perceptions of weight and size on social media. So obviously I've been doing social media for a really long time. I've worked brand side, I've worked creator side, and I've changed a lot, both physically and mentally, in all of that time. Physically, I have gone from, I don't know, a size 10 up to a size nearly 18, and all the way back down again, and I'm now about 14. In that time, I've seen and had multiple messages, often commenting on the way that I look, my appearance, and all not always nice, not always bad, and it's just, I don't know, it's just not okay, and I always feel like when you put yourself out on social media, you need to expect a level of opinion and a level of comment from people, but it doesn't entitle people to have opinions and comments on you that are gonna maybe negatively impact your mental health. And being told things like, oh, you look like a couch. Well, we call them sofas in England, FYI, but I know Americans call them couches, so I obviously knew that individual was an American, but saying that I look like a couch, like, why comment that? Why say something like that? I wasn't even particularly, like, large as it goes, or even particularly fat as it goes, in, you know, in comparing myself to lots of other, like, beautiful women, or men, by the way. But it's still, like, you know, someone still felt the need to say that and felt the need to try and be, like, mean. It did make me just sort of roll my eyes a bit, but at the same time, it upset me because that comment was received at a time when I was actively losing weight and I was feeling more confident about myself. And I went ahead and posted a video of myself wearing different dresses, and it was kind of therapeutic for me to do that because I hadn't really shown myself much on social media and it felt I couldn't and shouldn't because I was embarrassed about the way I looked. I also had comments about my stomach because I'd had an emergency C-section when I had my daughter, and that meant that it doesn't always happen, but for me, all my stomach muscles, they all just ripped apart and they all dropped, and then I had this huge kind of cavity in the middle of my stomach where if I pushed in, there was like right now there's muscle, but there was no muscle, and I almost could push like it was actually quite deep back. It almost felt like to my spine. I think that's an exaggeration, but it felt like that. And I still have issues with the scar, and I'm probably going to need reconstructive surgery at some point, but that's not something that I want to do right now, maybe in the next few years. But I've been left with quite a significant like issue there where it's uncomfortable, and it needs addressing at some point. But to comment on things like that on people on social media and be actively mean or unkind or negative, it's just not like okay. It doesn't matter what your views or opinions are, but and you're obviously entitled to them, but maybe sharing them with someone that whilst they're putting themselves out there on social media could still be vulnerable or could still be in a position where they're not mentally able to take that sort of criticism or negativity. Just scroll on. Like, I don't know how many people need to say this or how many people need to, you know, be in a position where they're made to feel awful, but just scroll on. If you're watching this and you are one of those individuals, please just scroll on. It doesn't take much to be kind, and it doesn't take much to go, would I like to hear that? Probably not. So yeah, just scroll on. So secondly, we are going to talk about Christmas and Christmas food and things like chocolate, mince pies, cake, roast potatoes, and all those yummy things that we get at Christmas, either as gifts or as food when we're going to visit friends and family, or Christmas markets, whatever it might be, wherever it might be. There's obviously going to be a level of feeling like you're going to gain weight or you're needing to watch what you eat all the time, and that's just not true. Oh, you off? For me, this time of year, there's obviously a level of concern that I might put the weight back on and I might fluctuate, but that's totally normal. Like, it's totally normal to fluctuate, and nobody's, well, very few people will be the exact same throughout life, especially women, especially mothers, who they've had their whole body, their hormones, everything like totally thrown up in the air and totally changed. So take that pressure off of yourselves and put it to one side, because it really doesn't matter. And it's okay to put on a bit of weight at Christmas. It's actually like natural and normal. If you think about it from a, in nature, you'll see lots of animals doing this. They will, you know, squirrels will go out and collect lots of nuts and bury them and hide them, and hedgehogs will eat loads and loads, and then like mice and things like that will eat lots and lots and get all like cozy and snuggly ready for the winter. And it's the same with us as humans. It's natural to put on a little bit of extra weight and be in that position, but it doesn't mean that you're, you know, there's anything wrong with you. It literally means the polar opposite. It just means you're a normal, healthy individual, and it's okay to, you know, eat a bit more, indulge a bit more, and it's like be in that mindset. It doesn't matter. I would say just do what's comfortable for you, and if you want to have an extra roast potato, like literally have one. It's not going to change much about your weight. That was something that I learned losing weight, that, you know, just because you might have an extra slice of toast in the morning for breakfast one day, or an extra potato at dinner, or you do go, oh, I'm actually going to have an ice cream today, like, as long as you don't do that like every single day regularly, like, it doesn't matter. It's fine, and it's okay to indulge, and it's okay to, you know, have an extra treat like that now and again, and that's fine at Christmas. And people will buy you chocolates, and they'll buy you biscuits, or like me, I love baking, and they might make you mince pies and all of those sorts of things, and it's totally fine to have them. And there should be no negativity around eating at Christmas, or generally really. And I think just take that away from your mindset. And if, like me, you've had people say things like, oh, you know, are you going to eat that? Or do you want to eat a bit more? Or, oh, should you really be having that? Or whatever the comment might be, just like, you know, just turn around to them and be like, why shouldn't I? Or just say, yes, of course I am. It's my body, my life, and I choose to eat and do what I want to do within what I feel are healthy limits. Still can't get my head around the way that people, you know, relatives, friends, strangers on social media feel entitled to have views and opinions on what we do eat and what we don't eat. And it's just crazy. Let's go on to the topic that I imagine most of you are here for, is how I lost the weight and I guess why. So Hazel's just gonna take over this video for a minute, aren't you? Yeah. So the reason I decided to lose weight was for health reasons. I have been diagnosed with Ehlers-Danlos syndrome, hypermobility, and also autonomic dysfunction. I'm not going to go into too much detail on these, but I'll just briefly like explain them. So Ehlers-Danlos hypermobility is an excess of stretchiness. I'm going to just explain it really like simply and briefly, so you kind of get an idea of it. So it's really super flexibility, super thing, like everything in my body just, you know, I can touch my, okay, I don't know if you can see that, but I can touch my thumb to there, my knees like hyperextend. So there's like a bend here, the same with my elbows, the same with lots of things on my body. So I'm like super flexible, super bendy, and that transfers over into organs, muscles, like it's everything. Autonomic dysfunction is to do with blood pressure, basically. It's to do with your heart and blood pressure in your body, and basically blood will pool at the bottom of my body if I'm sat down or lying down for too long, and then as soon as I stand up it goes whoosh, like right down there, and I get lightheaded, dizzy, I do faint and feel very nauseous, and just generally uncomfortable. The hypermobility side sounds cool and fun, and trust me, it was up until I was about, I don't know, 26, 27, maybe even 28. And yeah, it's been flared up. So both of these things I was like born with, but they've been flared up, they've come out, and the hypermobility side means that I can dislocate joints quite easily. Joints are painful, they get sore, and I struggle with movement sometimes. I struggle with getting out of bed some days. Some days I have really good days, other days my days are so bad that I physically struggle to move. And the pain is just unmanageable. And yes, I will spend days crying and being in super amounts of pain, and I've been prescribed some quite high potent, I will say, pain relief medication to manage and deal with that. The other thing that I wanted to do to manage and deal with that was address my diet and address my weight, because I personally, even though the doctor said it wouldn't impact it and it wouldn't change much, I personally felt that being so overweight as I was, for me, was impacting my joints and impacting my muscles and just putting like extra strain and pressure on my body that wasn't needed. I had quite high liver, I won't go into too much detail on it, but my liver was not functioning properly. It was quite dangerously, I didn't even know the words or want to go into that much because it was quite scary for me to hear. And there was quite high cholesterol in my body as well. Anyway, those sorts of things just set off alarm bells in my head, made me think, you need to change this, not just for your daughter and your animals and everything, but for yourself. So it got to a point where I thought, what do I do? Because I'd grown up with an eating disorder at university. Again, put on me by people commenting on my weight, commenting on my size, things not fitting me, whatever it might have been. And at university, prime fitness size, I was running 7 miles. It was insane. And when I look back on it, and if you're young and watching this, honestly, if you look back on it from my age down to your, like, you know, early 20s, you are perfect and gorgeous just how you are, and you do not need to change. And that is the same for any age. If you're mid 30s, 40s, 50s, you are perfect and gorgeous. If you feel like you need to change, you change. But I personally, I don't look at people, not anymore, and I have been that person, to look at people and be like, oh, just, you know, everyone's gorgeous. And I just, how boring would our world be if we all looked the same and all dressed the same and all acted the same? I changed my diet basically overnight. I decided to do you know what? It's a type of fasting basically. So I decided to do some fasting where I would not eat in the mornings and I would limit my calorie and food intake, not by counting them, not by anything like that. I would still eat what I wanted to eat when I wanted to eat it, but I would just limit things. So in the morning, I often don't feel hungry in the morning, which I don't know if that's normal or not, but I just don't. So Hazel has just jumped down. Sorry, she's now sitting on the floor next to me and my sofa is now covered in dog fur. But anyway, I was saying, yeah, I don't often feel hungry in the morning. So I decided, you know, why eat? I was just eating because I felt like society's told me I need to have breakfast, lunch and dinner. And by the way, you don't. You can have 8 meals, small meals a day, or you could have 100 small meals. I don't think you could probably fit that in, but you know what I mean. You can eat and do what you want to do. You don't have to just do things because it's a restaurant's got breakfast, lunch and dinner, or like society's telling you to do that. You can just do what you want to do. So some days I might have breakfast and we're going out with friends or family, or I want to have something with my daughter, but on the whole I just have a cup of tea or a cup of coffee or some orange juice or whatever it might be. I'd also then maybe not eat until like later on in the afternoon, and then have something light if I was starting to feel hungry, and then would maybe have something light at dinner with my daughter. I mean, for me that's what worked, just reducing my food intake, reducing my calorie intake and just eating less. It wasn't really something I consciously thought about every day, but I also did. So whilst I'm also saying I'd eat whatever I wanted, I would still be mindful of that. So I weirdly started to want to have more bananas and more oranges and more fruit-based stuff after about 3 months of doing this like intermittent fasting. And that was the snack that I would sort of like gravitate towards over maybe a slice of toast or a croissant or something like that. And I do still eat croissants. Yesterday I had a cinnamon, I don't really know what it was called, it's from Waitrose, like a cinnamon croissant-y thing. And really nice. So that's what I've been doing, that side of things. I've also been more conscious of health and having more supplements and things like that. I don't believe those have helped with weight loss, but I believe those have maybe balanced my hormones out a bit more. Doctors say they wouldn't really do much. I mean, that it's good to have vitamin D and vitamin C and all of those things. They don't think that that sort of thing helps with like weight loss or anything like that. And I've been taking the dog out when I physically feel like I can, going out in the garden more, and just trying to be a bit more calmer, less stressed and more mindful of things in life. There's no quick fix, there's nothing like magical that I've done that's going to help you lose weight or that helped me lose weight overnight. This has been quite an arduous process, and whilst I appreciate that I started this in March and we're now in December, and whilst that's like 9 months, and people will be like, that is a crazy amount of time to lose weight. Yes, it is, but my mum also lost weight years back, years and years ago, and she lost about 4 or 5 stone, maybe even more. And the fact is, you will lose weight quicker in those, you know, first 6 months to a year than you would like after that. So things have slowed down a bit now for me. But I'm at a comfortable weight. I'm happy with kind of how I am and I look. I'm still not where I want to be, but I'm fitting, you know, I fit into this dress again, which I've not worn for, you know, quite a few years. I think the last time I wore it was just after Tabitha was born, or maybe in the winter. I'm not entirely sure. I wouldn't want it in a video, but it was really tight on me. And now, you know, I've got room and it just feels more comfortable. And I'm just happier. And I do still want to lose more weight and get down to a, you know, a safe size for me, but that's going to take some more time, and I'm fully prepared for that, and I'm happy, and I don't personally care, I suppose, what people say negatively about me online or in real life. If I decide I want to eat a piece of cake or some chocolate or go out for a 3-course meal with my friends, whatever it might be, I'm me, I'm happy, and I hugely advocate for other people that feel that way as well. And I also want to just say there's nothing wrong with being like overweight or being fat or whatever it might be. Fat's not a bad word. Like, we need fat on us, women and men need fat, women more so. It's good to have like fat on your body. You know, I've fallen over countless times on dog walks or in the garden. Last year I fell quite significantly. We've got like a ledge in our garden, and I don't remember even how it happened. I think I might have tripped over Hazel when she was a puppy, slipped and fell onto gravel, broke a big plant pot. And I kid you not, if I'd been thin, I think I would have been in A&E with severe like damage to my body. Because I had that extra weight on me, it just like cushioned the blow. So I personally think there's pros to being a little bit chunky and a little bit bobbly in places. Nothing wrong with it. I'm never gonna be like, you know, a Victoria's Secret's model lookalike, And I, you know, as much as I think those women are gorgeous and beautiful, I don't want to be like that because it's not attainable for me and it's not sustainable for me. So yeah, I'm happy with how I am. And over Christmas, things are going to be just how they are. And I hope that's given you a little bit more of an insight. And yeah, thank you for watching my vlog today. Please do subscribe, share if you think it might be helpful for anyone you know, and leave me a comment below and we can chat more.